that we confer today in this historic ceremonial hall the highest honor of our university, the title of Doctor Honoris Causa awarded by the Department of Political Science and Public Administration of the National and Capodistrian University of Athens to the Senator of the United States of America, Mr. Robert Menendez. The conferment of this title to Robert Menendez is a homage to a distinguished American citizen with world renown, who is respected and esteemed by people from all sides of the political and social spectrum of his country, a great philhellen with extensive knowledge of the Greek issues, who supported and continues to support our country time and again and in critical moments.
And of course, I don't need to tell anyone in this room, the most persistent and proximate threat in the Eastern Mediterranean continues to be Turkey. Despite its status as a NATO ally, Turkey challenges Greek sovereignty with provocative overflights in the Aegean Sea. Violating airspace with fighter jets is simply unacceptable behavior from any country. It is definitely unacceptable behavior from a NATO country. And while it has been almost 5 decades, Turkey's illegal occupation of Cyprus remains a terrible stain on the history of Europe that must be resolved. Erdogan's bombast in Varosha last summer, in violation of UN Security Council resolutions, was just another reminder that he is not seriously interested in finding a tenable path forward. That there are more lawyers and journalists in Turkish jails. Think about the world and some of the horrible places in the world. That there are more lawyers and journalists in Turkish jails. That you have a NATO ally creating overflights over Greece's territorial airspace, seeks to afflict its territorial waters, wants to impede its right over its exclusive economic zone to drill for the energy deposits that exist, are so important today. That causes challenges for us in Libya, that seeks to have new attacks in Syria. This is not the actions of a responsible NATO member, and it is not the actions of a democracy. And as such, as far as I'm concerned, it should not see the possibility of having any superior weapons sold to it by the United States of America. It seeks